We have a leak in our roof. During heavy rain, there is water trickling in. My main complaint is that there's a leak in the roof. But what's also annoying is the leak is in the bedroom and the dripping makes an irritating sound that keeps me from sleeping. Also, the container that I placed below the leak is in the way when I'm walking through the bedroom. Whenever I need to fix something, my first thought goes to the 3D printer, regardless of whether it makes a lot of sense to use 3D printing. So how do I intend on fixing the leak with 3D printing? Well, I probably won't be able to fix the leak, but I think I can get rid of the container on the floor. I designed a gutter to collect the trickle. As the water runs along this wooden beam, the gutter needed to be quite long, so I split it into 6 parts. The end of each part is slightly smaller, so it fits neatly into the next one. After a quick tolerance test, I printed the parts. I recently found out that a chisel is a great tool for removing prints from the build plate. With a gentle stab, the prints pop right off. And to mount the gutter, I printed some holders that would attach it at a downward slope of approximately 1.5 degrees. I first had to clear the printer of any cats, and then I could start printing. I used duct tape to put the pieces together. The holders are easily attached with some nails, and at the end I simply hang a bucket. Problem solved! Well, at least nothing is standing in the way anymore, and after I put a cloth into the bucket, the loud dripping sounds also disappeared, so I can sleep again. I still hope the leak can be actually fixed soon. When I heard of 3D printing for the first time, I was immediately fascinated. But as cool as it seemed, I kind of had a hard time figuring out what I personally could use it for. So it would be many years until I actually got some hands-on experience with a 3D printer. And it turns out, once I started with 3D printing, there are basically endless use cases everywhere. I realized that my rain gutter project is maybe a bit far-fetched as far as useful 3D printing projects go. But since I got my 3D printer, I have been using it a lot for some really useful and cool things. Some examples include a cable holder, which I found on the Thingiverse website, to organize the many cables in my workshop. I also printed a window crank because the apartment I live in has windows that require a crank, but there was no crank when we moved in. We have a soap dish and a lid for the soap dish because some cats in this house somehow like to bite into soap. Yes, I'm looking at you. I also printed replacements for lost furniture parts like these small shelf holders, a cat safety power outlet cover, a holder for my handheld audio recorder, small measuring scoops, and many, many more. So if you've been thinking about what you could use a 3D printer for, maybe you got some inspiration from this. Thank you for watching. My goal for this YouTube channel is to upload at least one video per month. This month's video is definitely a bit shorter and simpler than my previous videos. That's because I have a lot on my plate with moving to a new town, and I'm also working on some bigger projects that I am not able to finish within a month. I'm hoping to be able to show you more about that soon. Stay tuned for that, and see you next time on Matu Makes!